This video here was also shot during one of my essential classes, and what I'll show you here is just me going through several rounds of working on the heavy bag. Now, it's gonna be freestyle because that's one of the things that I like to do to warm up, just cover many different bases. And in the first round here, I'm just going through a warm up, going through relaxed motions here, not really pushing all that hard, but basically making sure that my joints, my muscles, everything gets a good warm up, and I'm working my techniques at the same time. It's in a very relaxed fashion that I'll be doing this, and you'll also notice that I'm not wearing any gloves. The main reason why I do that is that it forces me to stay relaxed. I don't want to be hitting all out with within the first round of warming up, of getting ready. So to avoid injuries, I just don't put on the gloves and try to stay focused on the warming up process and not really just get into things a little bit too hard and just forget that I'm warming up, because that's a perfect way to get injuries or basically strain muscles or anything like that. So this is just a basic warm up in the first round. This is the second round, and in this round you'll see that I'm gonna start off easy and light again, but I did put on the gloves here to make sure that I can add a little bit more power once I feel that I'm warmed up enough. Another thing I'm gonna do here is do a couple of counters, for instance blocking a leg kick or a mid-level kick or something else like that that comes along, and then countering on the heavy bag. And then finally I'll do a little bit of clinching here and there just because I felt like it. Now, another thing you'll notice is that whenever the bag moves too much, what I like to do is just keep it still and bring it back a little bit more stationary, either using a strike or often using a push kick or some sort of knee block. And I'll do it in a way that not necessarily simulates me striking an opponent, but it's mainly just trying to stop the bag right away instead of me stopping my workout and having to grab the bag and put it stationary using the arms, because that breaks up the whole flow of training. So that's what I'm doing here in the second round. Now we're at round 3 and the warm-up is over, so I can start working on more technical aspects. In this case, what I like to do is pyramid combinations. Now, pyramid combos is something that I picked up from Rob Kaman, who is one of the all-time greats in Muay Thai and kickboxing. What it means is that you just do a whole sequence of techniques, one after the other, but you build it up. You start with one, you add another one, then a third one, and you always repeat 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Now, what I'm doing here is just repeating the last one again. So, for instance, with jab cross left hook, you just repeat the left hook a little bit. Another way of doing it, what I'll show you in a bit, is doing the same combination, but always finishing with a right leg kick or finishing with a left leg kick. So you're always working on your cardio, on your techniques, your distancing and so on, but you're also programming yourself to do a specific sequence. And that's one of the things that I like to do. Now, in between all those things, you'll also notice that I break it up a little bit before resuming the pyramid training, just to mix it up a little bit. You also notice that I like to do things left and right. This is round 4, and now that the warm-up is over, I'm going to work on leg techniques a little bit more. Mainly, I'm going to work mid to high level roundhouse kicks a lot more, because if you're not warmed up properly, that's when you get injured doing those, especially if you add a little bit of speed and power. I've had that happen in the past way too many times, so I'm a lot more careful now and do a good warm-up first. The second thing that you're going to see is I'm going to add more volume here to the whole round. Now that means that I want to do more techniques per combination, and on the other hand I also want to leave less time in between combinations. So the whole idea is get more of a cardio workout on the one hand, but on the other hand you're also simulating that you have an opponent that you have to keep under pressure. You have to be busy, you have to be active, you have to put a lot of pressure on him with continuous attacks. So this was me working on the heavy bag for a couple of rounds. I tried to give you some explanation on the why of certain things. Hope you enjoyed watching the video, and see you next time.